Hi, I'm Brittany Lung, and I would like to welcome you to this episode of Race Face Spotlight. Today, we're headed out west to Madera, California, where we find Race Face driver Joey Iest. Joey, how are you doing this evening?
I'm doing great, thank you. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Joey, you are currently racing in three different series, the 5150 Junior Late Model Series, the Nut Up Pro Late Model Series, and the Focus Midget Series. You've been a very busy young man this summer. So far this year, you've visited Victory Lane 8 times, 3 in the Junior Late Model, once in the Pro Late Model, and 4 times in the Focus Midget Series, including last weekend's win at Stockton 99 Speedway, keeping you undefeated in that series. Let's start with the Junior Late Model. 6 starts, 3 wins, 1 second place, 3 third place finishes. That's not bad. How would you rate your year so far?
Yeah, this season has started out really good. On our first 6 races, we finished in the podium each race. And we're just trying to stay consistent. And then we won 3 races this year, so it's been going good. And then we're the points leader now, too.
You sound like you're doing awesome. What do you think makes you so good in this series? What would you say is your secret sauce?
Mike Nick and the entire Nick Fowler Motorsports team has had really fast cars and great equipment, and they're really good coaching for everyone. And I just really like the track in Madera, and I've been racing there a while.
With 3 races left in the season, how do you like your chances of winning the championship?
A lot of it's just luck and trying to finish all the races and just trying to stay clean and be patient, and it's been a lot of fun.
Joey, we actually have a little surprise for you. We asked the same question to your car owner, Mike Naik. So let's go to Roseville, California and see what Mike has to say.
Hey, this is Mike from Naik Car Motorsports. Joey Iest here has been racing for us about a year now in our late models. He's won a couple junior late model races. He's leading the points in the junior late model. He's won a club pro late model race. And he's running in the top 3 in the pro late model races at Madera. Look for big things to come for him next year. He's doing a really good job. He's caught on real fast. We've been on a kind of the fast track with him, doing a lot of testing and a lot of racing. So look to see big things from Joey next year. Talk to you guys later. See ya.
Joey, it sounds like Mike is very impressed by your driving. 4 times this year, you've raced in the junior late model race, then jumped into the pro late model race on the same night. How tough is that to not only pull double duty, but have to adjust to different setups and different levels of competition?
Yeah, it's definitely a lot of laps, but the setups are pretty much the same. All they do is pull the restrictor plate out, and it gives it a little more power. And I won the 1 local club race this year, and then I got 3rd place on the last map TV series race. And there's a lot of fast people in that race, and just tried to own as much that could off of them.
I'd like to move now and ask you about the Focus Midgets. They're a smaller car, open wheel, no fenders, no roof, less horsepower, but very quick. You've won every race that you've competed in, including a win on Saturday at Stockton 99 Speedway. Tell us a little bit about this series and why you're so good at it.
Yeah, Randy Chastain does a really good job on that car, and that car handles really good and is fast. And the series is a lot of fun, and it's fun because the cars are really light and just fast, and I like it a lot.
So if you had to choose between the stock car and the open wheel car, what would you say is your preference and why?
I'd say the stock car, just because there's more opportunities and you could go further in the series. And then they're just a lot of fun to drive. And I like the big car counts at Madera, but both cars have a lot of fun.
Now, I've heard you have quite the simulator set up. How is that helping you hone your racecraft?
The simulator has helped me a lot, especially going from the late model to the midgets. Just getting me practice because everything's so different in between the cars. And it just helps me to get more smooth and consistent.
Joey, I'd like to know a little bit more about you, too. What do you like to do when you're not racing?
I live on a dairy farm, so this summer I've just been working a lot and riding quads and just doing anything outside I enjoy a lot.
Tell us a little bit more about your farm in Madeira, where you have been raised and you've grown up on this farm.
Yeah, we have dairy cows, and then we also, the feed for them is corn, wheat, and alfalfa. And then we also farm processing tomatoes, almonds, and pistachios and grapes.
Now, do you feel like the farming has also played a role in your work ethic on the track?
Yeah, I think it's helped me a lot, and then especially with the heat, being used to it in the long races, I think it helps me a lot.
Sounds like you've been very successful. Joey, thank you so much for taking your time here with us tonight. And is there anybody that you would like to thank?
Thank you. I'd like to thank Mike Nake and the entire Nake Carl Motorsports team, and Randy Chastain, Madeira Speedway, and Race Space. And then I'd like to thank my sponsors, CalAg Solutions, Power to Go, Richwood Meat, HSI, and Bacilla Foams, and friends at Jacqueline for all their support.
Well, there you have it. What an amazing young man. To learn more about Joey, check him out at joeyeastracing.com. Follow him on social media. Don't forget, if you want to catch up on any of the Race Face Spotlight shows, you can do so at raceface.tv on demand. Until next time, I'm Brittany Lung. Thank you for watching.